Over the long history of our planet, countless animals have roamed the Earth. Some species have survived to this day, while others, unfortunately, are considered extinct. But that doesn't mean we'll never get the chance to see a mammoth or scratch a saber-toothed cat behind the ear. Science is moving forward, and soon enough, researchers may literally bring vanished species back to life. Want to take a look at the future residents of a real-life Jurassic Park? Then let's go. Siberian unicorn. Most people probably believe that unicorns never existed. And it's true. The image of a beautiful white horse with a sparkling horn from fantasy stories is far from reality. That's because real unicorns looked quite different. In fact, this strange creature was an ancient relative of the rhinoceros that once lived across Eurasia. But it really did have a single horn. That's hard to deny. And according to recent findings, Siberian unicorns went extinct only about 26,000 years ago. That means they may very well have inspired the legends of magical one-horned beings. But perhaps the most exciting part is that these relatively young remains give scientists hope that the Siberian unicorn could one day be brought back to life. True, no one has started extracting its DNA yet, but it seems that bringing this unusual creature back to our planet wouldn't be all that difficult for geneticists. Giant sloth. At first glance, the bones of this creature might make you think you're looking at some kind of prehistoric bear. But in reality, it was a sloth, a very, very big sloth. These animals could grow up to 20 feet tall and went extinct not all that long ago, around 8,000 years ago. The last giant sloths lived in South America, where indigenous people often encountered them. Most likely, it was human hunters who drove them to extinction. Giant sloths moved far too slowly and couldn't, for example, hide up in trees, making them easy prey. Today, however, scientists have access to a huge number of remains, including bones and even skin. And while extracting DNA from them isn't simple, it is still possible. The only real problem lies with their closest relatives. Modern female sloths are far too small to carry a baby of such size. Still, given time, scientists will almost certainly find a way around that challenge. Mammoth. Of course, when talking about bringing back ancient animals, we can't forget the mammoth. After all, when it comes to extinct species, these shaggy elephants are usually the first that come to mind. Remains of these ancient giants are discovered fairly often, and often in such good condition that researchers can realistically hope to recover usable genetic material. In fact, several laboratories around the world are already working on this. Most likely, the source of DNA for cloning will be the thick hair of these prehistoric animals. And as for the surrogate mother of the first 21st century mammoth calf, an African elephant would be a perfect candidate, being nearly the same size. Meanwhile, in Siberia, enthusiasts have spent the past two decades preparing a home for these creatures by restoring the plant diversity of the so-called mammoth steppe. Interestingly, the disappearance of mammoths once led to the loss of much of this vegetation across the northern regions of the planet. Scientists now hope that with the return of these ancient animals, the rich prehistoric flora will return as well. Saber-toothed cat. So, we've covered the sloth and the mammoth. To complete the cast of the Ice Age, all that's missing is the saber-toothed cat. Still, when you look at the enormous fangs of this ancient feline, you might start to wonder whether bringing it back is such a good idea. Yet for scientists, saber-toothed cats are very real candidates for de-extinction. First of all, they went extinct relatively recently, around 11,000 years ago. And second, their fossilized remains have been preserved quite well, thanks to the cold environments they once lived in. And perhaps the strongest argument, they're just plain awesome. No joke. Saber-toothed cats are considered some of the most fascinating animals ever to walk the earth. Although, to be fair, our ancestors probably wouldn't have shared that opinion. Back then, people weren't exactly eager to resurrect creatures that wanted to eat them. Irish elk. Remember Thranduil's majestic mount in The Hobbit? Some say it was a moose, others an elk. The internet still hasn't reached a consensus on what that mysterious elven creature actually was. But the name doesn't matter as much as the fact that scientists may soon bring such a beast back to our world. Meet the Irish elk, an extinct species of giant deer that once roamed the earth. No, it's not the invention of animators or Peter Jackson's imagination, but a real animal, even if long gone. What set the Irish elk apart was its massive size and truly enormous antlers, stretching up to 13 feet across. Naturally, with such a crown on its head, it couldn't live among dense forests, and the species disappeared as woodlands expanded over open plains. Luckily for scientists, finding the remains of this giant isn't too difficult, and its distant descendants are still with us today, the ordinary European fallow deer. All of this makes the Irish elk one of the top contenders for de-extinction, which means that in just a few years, each of us might get the chance to feel a little like Thranduil from The Hobbit. Aurochs. The primordial wild ox, ancestor of all modern cattle, once roamed the woodlands and steppes of the Eastern Hemisphere. It was declared extinct in 1627, wiped out by relentless hunting and the destruction of its natural habitat. Yet despite being gone for nearly 400 years, the DNA of its descendants still closely resembles that of their ancient forebear. Efforts to bring back this massive bull have already been made. In Germany, during the 1920s and 1930s, scientists bred what became known as the Heck cattle. However, the result turned out to look less like the Aurochs than many existing cattle breeds. That's why a new project, the Toros Program, was launched in the Netherlands. Here, researchers are crossbreeding primitive European cattle in an attempt to create an animal that matches the Aurochs in appearance, size, and behavior. Another initiative is underway in Poland, where scientists from the Polish Aurochs Foundation plan to use DNA preserved in archaeological bones to attempt cloning. All in all, it's quite possible that humanity may soon have several versions of the Aurochs, each one closer to the mighty original. Dodo Bird. Familiar to many from Alice's Adventures in Wonderland, the dodo once lived in only one place on Earth, the island of Mauritius, east of Madagascar. It was first discovered and described by a Dutch expedition in 1598, and by 1662 the dodo had almost completely vanished. There was no ice age, no dramatic environmental shift. The problem was much simpler. These birds couldn't fly, as they had no natural predators in their habitat. For sailors, the comical dodo was an easy catch, and soon the species disappeared entirely. Later, it became the symbol of the Durrell Wildlife Conservation Trust, and a statue of the dodo still greets visitors at the entrance to the wildlife park that bears its name. Fortunately, scientists today have skeletal remains of these birds, which means there's a real chance the dodo could one day return. Rheobatrachus. To bring back an extinct animal, scientists need to clone it, and that requires finding DNA that's as intact as possible. This is why species that disappeared more recently have a clear advantage. Take, for example, the Australian frogs known as Rheobatrachus. These amphibians were remarkable because the females carried their eggs inside their stomachs until the young frogs literally hopped out of their mother's mouth. Yes, they were essentially kangaroo frogs. Unfortunately, for reasons still unknown, Rheobatrachus went extinct in the mid-1980s. Some point to environmental issues, while others blame natural problems within the population itself. We may never know the exact cause, but fortunately, back in the 1970s, scientists preserved samples of their tissues. And today, those samples are being used in an attempt to revive the species. In fact, researchers have already achieved a degree of success, creating several embryos. It's still far too early to speak of a true comeback, but science is patient, and when it comes to resurrecting life itself, it's worth the wait. Steller's sea cow. This enormous marine animal, reaching up to 26 feet in length and nearly 20 feet around, was first discovered in 1741 by Vitus Bering's expedition when it landed on the Commander Islands. Yet by 1768, These extraordinary creatures had been completely wiped out by hunters. Scientists believe that if Steller's sea cow had survived into modern times, it might have become the first domesticated marine animal. Its temperament was simply that gentle. And soon, we may find out for ourselves. Geneticists already have enough suitable material to extract DNA, and they are actively working on it. Before long, our familiar cow pastures may start to look a little different. Woolly rhinoceros. Yes, mammoths were not the only large, shaggy creatures roaming the frozen tundra of the Pleistocene. 10,000 years ago, woolly rhinoceroses wandered through the Arctic snows. Thanks to their thick fur, they managed well even in extreme cold, but they could not withstand the warming climate and growing competition from other animals. Early humans also made survival harder for them. And in the end, these remarkable animals went extinct. Fortunately, their remains have been well preserved, which means scientists can extract DNA. It's only a matter of time and funding. Most likely, the surrogate for a woolly rhino embryo would be the modern Sumatran rhinoceros, its closest living relative. If you could bring back any extinct animal, not just from this list, which one would you want to see alive? Let us know in the comments below. And don't forget to subscribe and turn on the notification bell so you never miss our new videos.